Hi everyone, welcome back. In my previous video, I have shown you how to enable editing options in Blazor Data Grid. In this video, I will show you how to perform CRUD operations in Blazor Data Grid with entity framework. In general, the entity framework reduces repetitive data operations in an application by generating the necessary database commands for reading or writing data in a database and executing them. Now, I'll proceed to show you how to add, update, and delete grid records using Entity Framework in Blazor WebAssembly app. First, I opened the existing Blazor WebAssembly app with Entity Framework and configured Blazor DataGrid component. Here, notice that this application contains three projects: client, server, and shard. To add the Entity Framework code to this application, I have already installed the necessary Microsoft Entity Framework Core package. Along with this, I would also install the Microsoft Entity Framework Core SQL Server package to use SQL database in the Entity Framework Core application. To know how to configure the Entity Framework in a Blazor WebAssembly app, please refer to the UG link shown in the above card. Let me explain the configurations done in this application. I hope you all know the first step to configure Entity Framework is to create a model class for the existing database. Under this shard project, I had already created the order details model class with fields like order ID, customer ID, and ship country with appropriate data types. Then I created a DB context class called order context and add the Northwind MDF file to connect Microsoft SQL Server database. Next, I created an order data access layer class, which acts as a data access layer for this application to perform CRUD operations, and I had defined the getAllOrders method to access orders database. The next step is to configure the Web API controller to consume data from the data access layer. So under this server project, I had created a Web API controller to retrieve data from the order data access layer class using its getAllOrders method. Finally, the DataGrid component must be configured using the Web API adapter. So under this client project, I would configure the DataGrid using the SF data manager to interact with the created Web API using Web API adapter and consume the data appropriately. I also enabled editing in the data grid with the available CRUD operations. I assigned the data model type class as order details to the t-value property of sfgrid tag. I have mentioned specific columns to be displayed in grid using grid columns tag and set the order ID column as a primary column to perform CRUD operations. Then I enabled the isIdentity property to consider this column as identity column, which will be in disabled state in add request, and its value will be auto incremented. Look at the output page. The grid component is rendered with columns like order ID, customer ID, and ship country based on the data from the orders database using the entity framework. Here I'm going to handle CRUD operations in the data access layer class. Within this order data access layer class, I need to define the methods to perform insert, update, and delete operations. First, I define the addOrder method to add a new record to the database. Here, the newly added record details are bound to the order parameter. To add that record to the database, I call the add method and pass the parameter order. Then I also need to call the saveChanges method to save this newly inserted record to the database. Next, I define the updateOrder method to update the modified record. I assign the modified record to the database by passing the details from the order parameter. Then I call the saveChanges method to save the modified records to the database. Finally, to delete records from the database, I define the deleteOrder method and search for the records to be deleted using the find method from dbContext with the help of the ID parameter. Then I use the remove method from dbContext to delete the records from the database. Then I call the save changes method to save the above changes. After handling the CRUD in the data access layer class, I need to create post, put and delete methods in the web API controller to perform CRUD operations and return the resultant data. In the post method, I call the add order method from the order data access layer class and pass the parameter order, which is the order model data bound using from body attribute. Similarly, I call the update order and delete order methods from the order data access layer class inside the put and delete methods respectively. Here, I will set the breakpoint for post, put and delete methods to demonstrate the CRUD operations. Now, I will run the sample and show you the output. Look at the output page now. When I perform insert, the SF data manager will make a request to the post actions defined in the web API controller based on the route name, and the inserter data will be updated to the database. Then I select any record and click the edit button in the toolbar. The request will be made for put action and update the modified record details in database. At last, I select a row and click delete button in the toolbar. The request will be made for delete action and delete the records from database. Let me make a quick recall of what we have seen so far in this video. I showed you how to handle CRUD operations, add, update and delete in a Blazor data grid with entity framework. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the description below. You can also see about getting a free license key to use our Blazor products if you are eligible for our community license. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give a like and subscribe to our channel. Thank you.